natural disasters are known to cause devastating effects on the areas they victimize. Their floods, wind, and other attributes reshape the land they conquer, destroying structure and taking life. Even after these disasters take place, areas struggle to recover from the damage done. People are dealt with rubble, ruined properties, and new emerging dangers, such as the spread of pathogen. Severe weather occurrences accelerate the spread of disease. One such disease that often surfaces after natural disasters is known as mucormycosis, a flesh-eating fungus. This particular disease has been linked to many natural disasters, including the Joplin tornado in 2011, a volcanic eruption in Colombia in 1985, the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami, and is now speculated as a possible danger following hurricanes Harvey, Irma, and Maria. The fungus is reported to have taken the lives of many who were able to survive the disasters that introduced it to the area. People with wounds that are exposed to floodwaters are at risk of catching the disease. People with weakened immune systems are particularly at risk of inhaling the disease through mold spores. Once inside the body, the fungus spreads through the bloodstream, causing a variety of symptoms including sinus pain, fever, and black drainage from the eyes. The fungus also causes necrosis, killing off large areas of tissue. Mortality rates range from 46 to 96%, depending on the health of the patient, the type of fungus, and the part of the body the fungus is attacking. Luckily, the disease is very rare, with an estimated annual rate of 1.7 cases in a million. May 22, 2011, an EF5 tornado, approximately 1 mile wide, that lasted for 38 minutes with wind speeds over 200 miles per hour, tore through Joplin, Missouri, leaving 158 fatalities and 1,100 injured people in its wake. About 18% of the Joplin population was left in poverty after being torn apart by the strong tornado, but nonetheless, there were still survivors. That being until a strange occurrence of reported injuries related to a fungus that does not cause harm to humans. The fungus goes by the name of Apophysomyces trapeziformis, a soil-dwelling zygomycete that is only really known for scavenging dead plants. That is, until the storm. With only 74 other reported cases of this fungus, infecting and harming other humans and mammals in general, it was odd as to why people were coming to the hospital after the tornado with this specific injury. It was found that this fungus was able to hitch a ride onto the objects that were being tossed through the sky and became directly injected into the bloodstream by way of people getting stabbed, scraped, or scratched by objects flying through the air during the tornado. The objects were being thrown around in 200 miles per hour winds, thus being able to easily be injected like a needle into the bloodstream of individuals who were injured with a resulting open wound. 13 people were infected by A. trapeziformis. It was found that those who were infected also lived in the zone of the most destruction from the EF5 tornado. When the fungus is injected via flying object into the individuals, it begins to infiltrate the walls and insides of blood vessels, forming nets that cause blood clots to block blood flow and create dead tissue around the initial wound. 5 of the 13 infected had died within 2 weeks of being sampled for the fungus. 3 of those 5 had the fungus listed as the primary contributor to the cause of death of the individual. There is still no exact cure or explanation about this fungus and how it affects humans because the cases are few and far between. It remains unsolved and just another mystery about fungi. Although dust storms are frequent in the valley, the intensity of the San Joaquin Valley dust storm in December 20, 1977 was a unique experience for Valley residents. Some of the strongest winds ever recorded in California history slammed into the southern San Joaquin Valley that day and, combined with the extraordinary dry soil, produced a fearsome dust and sandstorm, which had a wind speed of 300 kilometers an hour. The strong winds had generated a wall of dust that was 5,000 feet high, trapping people indoors with winds carrying more than 25 million metric tons of soil, causing widespread property damage and heavy losses of soil and wildlife. An outbreak of fungal respiratory infection had occurred shortly after the dust storm in San Joaquin Valley. This fungal infection is caused by the fungus Coccidiosis immitis, which is a dimorphic fungus growing in semi-arid soil. It is regularly found in parts of South America, southwestern United States, and northern Mexico. During extended periods of dryness, the fungal spores remain dormant. With rainfall, the spores develop elongated filaments which break off and are dispersed into the air by soil disruption due to dust storms. Coccidioidomycosis, or commonly called valley fever, is a fungal respiratory infection contracted by mammals such as humans and animals from inhaling Coccidioides spores. The spores change form in tissues of the body and are not contagious in tissue form. Most individuals will acquire immunity from infection and won't get infected again unless the person's immune system is suppressed. The symptoms of valley fever are coughing, chest pain, fever, rashes, headaches, and joint pains. However, these symptoms are not unique to valley fever alone and will appear within 1 to 3 weeks of inhaling Coccidioides spores. Although there is no cure for valley fever, 60% of people will not even know that they have been infected and may experience little to no symptoms at all and will be able to recover without treatment. Tsunamis are massive waves that cause immense damage and are typically the aftermath of an earthquake that occurs in the ocean. The Great Japan Earthquake and Tsunami was a relatively recent natural disaster that had terrible health effects on the victims in the aftermath. The initial earthquake occurred on March 11, 2011, outside of Tokyo. The earthquake was 9.1 magnitude, thus causing 30-foot waves to crash into the city and coast. The 2011 Great Japan Earthquake and Tsunami caused 22,000 people to die or go missing. This tsunami caused many people to have near-drowning experiences and aspirate contaminated water. This contaminated water can lead to diseases caused by Aspergillus and Pseudalcharia boidei. These fungal infections cause near-drowning victims to suffer from pneumonia, sinus, and pulmonary infections. Unfortunately, it is difficult to tell how many cases there were from fungal pathogens, considering the lack of resources and timing. Natural disasters have spread pathogen throughout history and have advocated for the spread of fungi around the world and helping them infect their host. This adds an entire additional layer to the dangers of natural disasters and the destruction they continue to bring.